If you're in your 20s or 30s, you may be thinking about a comfortable retirement that may still feel distant. While it may seem like your options are limited, one strategy stands out among the rest, which is investing early. Securing a comfortable life inevitably requires a substantial amount of wealth, and one of the most effective ways to achieve this, especially for the working class, is through the power of smart investments. Imagine this. You decide to allocate $400 per month and earn a 10% return on your investments. If you engage on this journey at the age of 25 and remain committed until you reach 60, your retirement account will flourish to an impressive $1,312,157. However, if you postpone your investment journey until you're 40, instead of 25, you'd only have a fraction of that amount, $277,611 to be exact. While this example may not come as a groundbreaking revelation, it highlights a fundamental truth. It's a concept you've likely heard before, but for the majority of people, it remains the tried and true method to grow wealth and establish a financial safety net to lean on during more challenging times. By taking the initiative to start early, you set yourself up for success. And in today's video, we're going to explore some of the most important assets and investment decisions you can make while young. Number 1. Growth and dividend stocks. In your 20s and 30s, taking risks with your investments can be advantageous, because you have time to recover if you encounter losses. Investing in stocks specifically provides a great opportunity to allocate a portion of your money into ventures with high risk and high potential rewards. Growth stocks are stocks that are expected to experience significantly higher growth rates compared to the industry average. These stocks generate more sustainable positive cash flows and revenues than their counterparts. On the other hand, dividend stocks are typically shares of financially stable and mature companies. This means that their share prices tend to be less volatile compared to growth stocks. Including dividend stocks in your investment portfolio from a young age can bring long-term benefits, such as potential for consistent income generation, compounding returns, and increased overall portfolio stability. Number 2. Index funds. Index funds are investment funds that aim to replicate the performance of a specific market index, such as the S&P 500. It is an excellent choice for beginners in investing because they offer several advantages. They are low-cost diversified investment vehicles that can help you build wealth over time. One of the reasons why index funds are ideal for beginners is their simplicity and accessibility. They are easy to understand and invest in, with no minimum investment requirements. Additionally, index funds offer tax efficiency, as they typically generate capital gains distributions that are taxed at a lower rate than ordinary income. When examining historical data, index funds demonstrate a strong track record. For instance, over the past 50 years, the S&P 500 has delivered an average annual return of 10% and has only experienced 2 negative years during that period. Furthermore, the S&P 500 has never recorded a negative 10-year return. While past performance doesn't guarantee future results, this historical data indicates the consistent success of index funds, outperforming actively managed funds and proving to be a reliable long-term investment option for growing wealth. Number 3. Exchange-traded funds. Now let's explore ETFs, which bear resemblance to the index funds we discussed earlier. ETFs, short for exchange-traded funds, are collections of securities that encompass various assets like stocks, bonds, and gold. This similarity with index funds lies in their structure. ETFs can be traded on exchanges, similar to stocks, allowing investors to buy and sell shares. The versatility of ETFs makes them valuable tools for investing in different areas. Investors can choose to invest in broad market indices such as the S&P 500, or focus on specific sectors, like technology or health. They can even narrow down their investment to subsectors, such as social media or robotics. Some examples of ETFs include the Schwab US Large Cap ETF, Global X Robotics and Artificial Intelligence ETF, and iShares Global Clean Energy ETF. These ETFs provide opportunities for investors to access various segments of the market and align their investments with specific themes or areas of interest. Number 4. Real estate. Real estate is a really good investment choice with lots of benefits. One reason is that there's always a shortage of houses, so real estate values usually go up. If you want to start investing in real estate, a good first step is to buy your own home. Having your own place reduces expenses like rent, and it also opens doors to expand your real estate portfolio. You could think about building apartments, townhouses, offices, or other commercial properties. If you can't directly invest in real estate, don't worry, there are other options you can try. Some websites let you invest in real estate with a small amount, even as low as $500. The money you contribute gets combined with what other investors put in, and together it's used to invest in real estate properties. These investment options are called real estate investment trusts. Number 5. Startup business. Investing in startup businesses is another option to consider in your 20s. It has the potential for incredible returns on investment. You don't necessarily need to start your own business. Instead, you can invest in other people's businesses and become a shareholder. For example, you can be an angel investor and support a founder you trust. Your investment can take the form of a convertible note that can turn into a loan under specific conditions. Another avenue for investing in startups is through crowdfunding. Many crowdfunding platforms showcase promising businesses with high growth potential. Before investing, it's important to thoroughly research the founder and understand the company's story. Look for companies with a compelling narrative and founders who have relevant education, experience, or training in the industry. Another option is to work with a venture capital fund. If you become an accredited investor, you can enter the world of venture capitalism. However, keep in mind that these funds often require a minimum investment amount and have strict qualifications. Number 6. Treasury bills. Investing in treasury bills is essential for all investors, regardless of their age. There is no better time to regularly purchase treasury bills than when you're young. Treasury bills are short-term debt instruments guaranteed by the government. They are issued to fund expenses and regulate the money supply. These bills come in three different tenors: 90 days, 182 days, and 364 days. As individuals, we all have financial obligations to fulfill, such as tuition fees, rent, or car loan payments. Investing the available money into treasury bills allows you to easily cash out when these bills become due. This aligns with the financial principle of asset and liability matching, which involves acquiring an asset to cover future liabilities. The best part is that treasury bills carry no risk, ensuring that your returns are guaranteed, unlike other investment options. Moreover, the returns they generate are quite decent. So, why not consider investing in them? Number 7. Commodities. In economics, a commodity is an economic good, like a resource, that can be easily traded because it's treated as equal regardless of its origin. There are different ways to invest in commodities, each with its own approach. One way is to buy physical raw commodities, such as precious metals like gold or silver, in different amounts. Another way is through futures contracts or special investment products that follow specific commodity indices. It's important to know that these types of investments can be risky and complicated, usually better suited for experienced investors. Another option is to invest in mutual funds that focus on businesses related to commodities. For example, an oil and gas fund would own stocks of companies involved in finding, refining, storing, and selling energy. Investing in commodities has its advantages. It helps diversify your investments, has the potential for good returns, and can act as protection against rising prices. Commodities have historically performed well during times of inflation, so they can be valuable assets to consider owning. And number 8. Cryptocurrencies and initial coin offerings. Recently, cryptocurrencies and initial coin offerings have caught the attention of traditional investors. With billions of dollars raised through ICO financing and a wide range of cryptocurrencies available, these dynamic markets are enticing for investors. However, these investment products can be complex and challenging for individual investors to understand and assess their risk levels. Despite this complexity, it is evident that cryptocurrencies have shown remarkably high returns. The potential returns can vary significantly, ranging from 12% to as high as 200%. Some ICOs have even delivered extraordinary performance. For example, ODA achieved a return on investment of 13,000 times, which means if you had invested $1 during its offering, you would have made $13,000. That concludes today's video. I hope it was informative and beneficial to you. If you found it helpful, please give it a thumbs up. I welcome your feedback, so feel free to share your thoughts in the comments section below. Lastly, remember to subscribe and turn on notifications so that you don't miss any future videos. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.